Good morning. We're learning Maseches Eruvin, chapter 9, Daf Pei Tes 89. And the name of the chapter is Kol Gagot. Kol Gagot. So the law of Eruvin Chatzeros prohibits carrying objects from private domain to another private domain if the residents of the two areas have not joined in an Eruv. The Mishnah proceeds to clarify what constitutes another domain in regard to this law. Kol gagot ha'ir reshut achat, all adjoining roofs of the town are one domain. Ubilvad, even though the houses below are owned and occupied by different people, that is, carrying from one roof to another is permitted, even if the resident below did not join an Eruv. So that's an interesting concept. All the roofs are considered one reshut, one domain. But number one tells us that the Mishnah is referring to adjoining roofs.
When they're together?
Yeah, meaning like if you look at the townhouses, so they have one roof. As regards throwing an object between non-adjoining roof, see Eirachayim. So the Shulchan Aruch will discuss when it's separate roofs. Ubilvad shlei gagava yud o namuch yud. Provided that one roof is not 10 tfochim higher or lower than the other roof. So when do I call it one reshut if it's one height? But one is higher than the other, 10 tfochim, or less than 10 tfochim, it's not considered one reshut. Div Rabbi Meir, these are the words of Rabbi Meir. But the rabbi said, each roof is a domain unto itself. Therefore, what's the difference what's a nafkamina, which means like, halachically, what would be the difference if I say it's one roof, or it's reshut bifne atzmo, it's a domain unto itself? So the bottom line is, if the residents below did not join in an eruv, carrying from one roof to another is forbidden. Rabbi Shimon Omer, Shimon says, Echad gagot, ve'echad chatzirot, ve'echad karpifot, roofs, chatzirot, and karpafs, reshut achat hein lechelim, sheshavtu letochan, are one domain in regard to utensils that began the Shabbat in one of these areas. If the utensils began the Shabbat on the roof, it's considered reshut achat. Ve'lo lechelim sheshavtu b'toch habayit, but not in regard to utensils that began in Shabbat in the house. So even if utensil that began the Shabbat in the house was lawfully brought out to an outdoor enclosure, it may not be transferred to another outdoor enclosure. So when I'm allowed to carry, according to Rabbi Shimon, if the utensil was on the roof before Shabbat, at the onset of Shabbat. Yati v'abai barav merubichen orav v'yasi v'abai gabayu v'yasi v'kamwe. So, Bish l'mar abonon, we understand the opinion of the sages who prohibit all transfers between roofs. They prohibit it. You can't transfer. Sovri, why? Kishem shediur chaluk ilmatu kadu chaluk ilmatu. They say the same way, that downstairs it's your reshut, your house. So upstairs is also your roof. No such a thing as one roof to all. El Rab Meir Maikasov. So what is that? Why Rabbi Meir says that it's considered one reshut? All the roofs are considered one domain. If he holds like the rabbis, that the same way that downstairs, it's your house, it's private reshut, private domain, and your neighbor's house is private domain, so upstairs it should be the same, yeah, your roof. So he obviously doesn't hold that way. So yes, it would be a challenging thing. Why do you call it reshut achat? One domain. And if he says that anything that is higher than 10 tefachim is considered one reshut. Remember, we said that one is a considered reshut achat when it's all leveled. But if it's one, if it's higher, 10 roof or low, then it's not. He said, if he's considering wherever there is, it said in the language of the Gemara, it says, if Rabbi Meir holds, in halukin, the chol amala miyud reshut, that everything that is higher than you, there's one reshut. So what difference does it make if one is a little bit taller and one is less, ten tefachim higher or low? Meaning, the moment that you say that anything above ten tefachim is considered one reshut, one domain. So why you differentiate if the roof is a little bit higher and one side is a little bit lower? Because we said that when Rabbi Meir considers all the roofs as one reshut, on the same level, but if one is higher, one is lower, it's not. Just about 1 second. The moment that it's higher than 10 tefachim, it should be all one reshut. That's how you see things. That's how Rabbi Meir's opinion. So what difference does it make if one is higher, one is lower? As long as it's above 10 tefachim.
Okay.
Just say, as long as it's higher than 10 for him, okay. It should be one reshut. Ela amar lehu abai. Lo shemir luchu adam rab. Didn't you hear, didn't you listen, or didn't you learn what Rav Yitzchak Bar Avdimi said? Omer haya Rav Meir, kol makom shata motze shtei reshuyot v'reshut achat. Wherever you find two domains that are one domain. What does it mean, two domains that are one? Is it two or is it one? Shtei reshuyot v'hen reshut achat. Two domains that are one domain. That is two areas.
Under one roof, maybe.
Let's see. The two areas are distinct as they are separated by a height of 10 tefachim, but they are in fact a single domain. They both a reshut ayachid. So he calls it reshut achat because they are both reshut ayachid. But they are separated by height of 10 tefachim. The two areas are distinct as they are separated by a height of 10 tefachim, but they are in fact a single domain. Kegon, and he brings an example. He's explaining it now. Kegon. Kegon means, this is the example, such as, Amud bereshut ha'echid, you have Amud, a pillar in private domain. Gavo asara v'rachav arba. So it's 10 by 4. Pillar 10 by 4. 10 height, 4 width. 20 inches width and 50 inches tall. He says, Asur lechatef alav. You're not allowed to rearrange your burden. In other words, it's not makom petu. We learned yesterday that if it's less than fachim, then you're allowed to adjust your burden. But you are not allowed to transfer from Rishut Echid to Rishut Arabin. But if it's 10 by 4, he says, Asur lechatef alav, you are not allowed to rearrange your burden, your load. Why? Gezerah, even though this action involves only the transfer of an object from Rishut Echid to another. Why? Because 10 by 4 is what? 10 by 4 is considered Rishut Echid. So you're just transferring from Rishut Echid to another Rishut Echid. It's still forbidden. Why? Gezerah mishum tel b'rishut harabim. The ban is a safeguard against doing the same on an elevation in Rishut harabim. And if a person standing in Rishut harabim were to place his burden on elevation 10 tefachim high by 4 tefachim wide, he would thereby commit the forbidden labor of transferring between Rishut harabim and Rishut Echid on the Shabbat. So it says like this. If this is Rishut Hayachid, right? You are in Rishut Hayachid. You have a load on your back. And this thing, see this line? This is 10 by 4. So if I were to take the load from here and put it over here, I transfer from Rishut Hayachid to Rishut Hayachid. Mm-hmm. Rabbi says, don't do it. Why? Because if you will do it, it might happen that one day you will be in Rishut Arabim. Imagine now, this is Rishut Arabim. and you will be, this is 10 by 4, therefore it's a Reshut HaYachid, then you will transfer from Reshut HaRabim to Reshut HaYachid, because you used to, every time you see 10 by 4, you used to adjust your load. So they don't want you to do it.
Okay. Facts around the Torah.
Mm-hmm. So now you can see what Shtei Reshuyot Shein Reshut Achat. Shtei Reshuyot means, on one hand, it could be, it's from the roof perspective, it's two different areas. One is higher than the other, but on bottom line, it's Reshut Echid. It's Reshut Echid. So it says Gezeram Shum. Now Achanami. So in our case, Gezeram Mishum Tal Reshut Arabim. So too in regards to roof separated by a height of 10 tefachim. Rabbi Meir said, Rabbi Meir prohibits the transfer of object between the roofs as a safeguard against transferring an object from Reshut HaRabim to an elevation in Reshut HaRabim that is 10 tefachim high and 4 tefachim wide. Savur mina afilu machtesh afilu gigit. Abaye bar Avin and Rabbi Chanina bar Avin understood from this explanation that Rabbi Meir bans moving object in a Reshut HaYachid even from the floor to a mortar or a barrel. Movable object that are 10 tefachim high and 4 tefachim wide. Amar lehu, so that's machteshet and gigit. Machteshet and gigit. Mortar or a barrel. Gigit is a barrel and machteshet is the mortar. I think it's some kind of a grinder.
Yeah, mortar and pestle, like the pharmacists used to do back in the day when they made the medicine.
You know when you have, some people like take spices and crush the spices.
Yeah. Same,
so that's called
same.
A mortar. And in Hebrew it's machteshet, in Aramaic it's called machteshet. And gigit is a barrel, it's just a container. And so he says, afilu machteshet v'gigit, you shouldn't be carrying these things. It says Rabbi Meir, understood from this explanation that Rabbi Meir bans moving object in Reshut HaYachid even from the floor to a mortar or a barrel. To a mortar, meaning moving things to these two utensils, movable object that are 10 tefachim high and 4 tefachim wide. That's have to be a pretty big box. Right, 10 by 4, 50 inches by 20 inches. It's a pretty big box. Amar lo abai achi amar mar. This is what the master said. Lo amar Rabbi Meir el amud v'amata rechaim. Rabbi Meir did not state his ban except in regard to a post or the base of the millstones that is in a reshut hayachid and 10 tefachim high and 4 tefachim wide. Hoil v'adam kover le'makom. Since a person assigns these objects a set place, since these are stationary objects, meaning they are not movable objects, it's like an ATM machine, you put it in there for a couple of years, you're not planning on moving it. They resemble an elevation in Reshut HaRabim. It's like elevation because it's stationary there. It's going to stay there for a long time. It's like considered elevation. But Rabbi Meir did not extend this ban to movable objects. Rabbi Meir did not extend this ban to movable objects. So when are you not allowed to move with non-movable object? Movable object, you're allowed to. Did not extend this ban to movable object. The Gemara questions the premise of Rabbi Meir prohibits moving an object to a fixed 10 tefach elevation in a Reshut HaYachid. There is the case of a wall between two chatzirot. Two courtyards has a wall in between, which is set in its place. The wall is stationary. The wall is not going anywhere. According to Abaye, Rabbi Meir should prohibit moving an object from the chatzir to the wall. According to Abaye, Rabbi Meir should prohibit moving an object from the chatzir to the wall. Why? Because the wall is stationary. Ve'amar Rabbi Yehuda, k'shetim tzelema. Upon careful analysis, you will find Ledir Rabbi Meir, that according to the opinion of Rabbi Meir, Gagin Reshut Latzman, Chatzirot Reshut Latzman, Karpifot Reshut Latzman, roofs are a domain unto themselves, Chatzirot are a domain unto themselves, Karpavs are a domain unto themselves. That is, Rabbi Meir permits caring within each type of area, even between enclosures owned by different people who have not joined in an eruv. From one person's chatzer, for example, from one person's chatzer to another person's chatzer, or from one person's karpaf to another person's karpaf, but he does not permit carrying between two types of area, from chatzer to karpaf and vice versa. Now, what does chatzerot are a domain unto themselves mean? My love, the shori le taltula derech kesef. Does it not mean that it is permitted to transfer an object from one chatzer to another, from one chatzer to the other, via the wall that separates them, by placing the object on the wall, and from there to the second chatzer? But since the wall separating chatzerot is 10 tfachim high, and generally at least 4 tfachim thick, Rabbi Meir should forbid this. Let's see what it says in 14. Apparently then, Rabbi Meir does not ban moving an object in a reshut hayachid to a fixed elevation of 10 tfachim. And there must be some other reason why he forbids carrying between a high roof and a low one. So what is the real reason why Rabbi Meir prohibits transferring from a high roof to a low roof? He said you shouldn't do it. It seems like it's not stationary and non-stationary issue, because in the case of a wall which is stationary, he says you're allowed to put from Reshut HaYachid onto the wall. Amar Avuna Bar Yehuda Amar Rav Sheshes Lo Lahachnis Lo Yisider Psochim. Rabbi Meir does not permit placing object on and then over the wall. Rabbi Yehuda meant only that Rabbi Meir permits one to bring object in and out of the chatzerot through entrances that are in the intervening wall. But he does not permit moving an object to a 10 tefach fixed elevation in Reshut HaYachid, and that is why he stipulates that the Mishnah, in the Mishnah, that one roof should not be 10 tefachim higher than the other. So according to Rav Huna, the son of Rav Yehuda, in the name of Rav Sheshet, he does not permit moving an object to a 10 tefachim fixed elevation, Reshut HaYachid, and that is why he stipulates in the Mishnah that one roof should not be 10 tefachim higher than the other. Okay, so the Gemara now discusses that part of the Mishnah which reads, V'chachamim omrim kol echad ve'echad reshut b'fnei atzmo. Sages say each roof is a domain unto itself, and one may not carry from one person's roof to another person's roof, unless the two are merged through an eruv, but carrying on each roof remains permitted. So the opinion of Chachamim is exactly opposite of the opinion of Rabbi Meir. Why? Because Rabbi Meir says it's considered one reshut and you're allowed to carry. Chachamim said no, it's private. Each one is its own private reshut. So my roof and your roof, my roof is reshut echid, your roof is reshut echid. The only way for me to transfer from my roof to your roof is to make a roof. If you don't do a roof, you cannot transfer. Rav says, we may not carry either adjoining roof except within 4 amot. Shmuel says it is permitted to carry on the entire roof. Only carrying from roof to roof is prohibited. So Shmuel said it's permitted. Shmuel said that according to the sages, it is permitted to carry on the entire roof. Only carrying from roof to roof is prohibited. So Shmuel, in a way, speaks, says like Rabbi Meir. But Shmuel says that according to the sages, permitted to care from only from roof. It is permitted to carry on the entire roof. Only carrying from roof to roof is prohibited. What is considered roof to roof? So let's see. The Gemara now proceeds to explain the source of the dispute. When the roofs are separated by walls that are visible to a person who is standing on the roof and looking directly down, there is a space between the two buildings so that a person standing on the roof and looking directly down can see the walls below that separates the two buildings. So he can see that the two buildings are separated. Mm-hmm. Everyone, Rav and Shmuel, agrees that these walls are viewed as a valid separation between the roofs and carrying on each roof area is unreservedly permitted.
Not permitted.
Keep ligi. So when does Rav and Shmuel argue? The mechitzot she'inan nikaot, walls that are not visible from the roof. Two buildings are attached. Rav amar ein metaltelim bo ela v'dalemot. Rav says we may not carry on either roof, except within four amot. Why? Lo yomar gud asik mechitzoso. We mentioned this rule yesterday. Because he does not apply the rule of extend and raise up the partition. Like the same idea of lovewood, but going the other way around. Extend and raise up the partition. The partition goes all the way up. It says in 17, Tosfos asserts that the key factor in preventing the rule of good asik from applying in this case is the extension of the roof beyond the wall below. When a roof extends beyond the wall, we do not apply good asik, even if there is no adjoining roof and the wall below is visible from the roof. I think in the introduction to this chapter 9, it says good asik, extend and raise up the partition. This is a biblical rule, halacha l'maisha misinai, that allows us to view a legal partition as extending upward, ad infinitum, meaning go all the way to the sky.
What do you gain, Rabbi? If these two roofs are like this, and we have this rule that goes to the sky, what do you gain if they are separated? One roof is here.
That's what the Gemara says, the machloket between Rav and Shmuel.
But what do you gain if the roof goes together? Still have a separation between them.
Right, so according to one opinion, the separation is exist and therefore you're not allowed to transfer from one to another. According to the other opinion, it's not considered separation and therefore you'll be allowed to carry. So, one second. So it says, extend and raise up the partition. This is a biblical rule. Allows us to view a legal partition extending upward ad infinitum. The primary application of this rule in this chapter involves using the walls of a house to partition the house roof area, even though there are no walls physically encompassing that roof area. So he is trying to say that if I'm applying this rule, Even though I don't see the walls, it should be as if it's going upward, and therefore there is a separation, even though it's one roof, but it's as if the separation exists between one roof and the other.
Even if it's together.
What is the rabbi saying? We're looking at it as one reshut, meaning that they do not apply the rule of good asik. But if they were to apply it, then the partition goes all the way to the sky.
Then it's separation.
There's another rule. It's called Pitikra. Pitikra is the rule that the walls are extending down, not extending up. Good asig mechitzos, so it's extend and raise up the partition. It goes up. Lavud is similar to pitiku. The edge of the roof extends downward and seals. This is another biblical rule which allows us to view the edge of a roof or a beam as continuing toward the ground and forming partition. When the rule applies in an open area, can be considered partition by which. Okay, so this is not lavud, because lavud is saying three tefachim is considered close.
Mm-hmm.
The pitikra, we didn't get to it yet, but pitikra is if you imagine a house, and it's called overhang, right? So this is, let's say, the roof of the house. This is the house, and the roof is like this, right? So now you have a little bit of an area. This area down here is not, it's under the roof, but it's not, the wall is here.
This is the overhang.
This is the wall, this is considered overhang. It's like over and it's hanging, right? So that's where they put the edge, mm-hmm, of the roof is here. Mm-hmm. So this area is considered like, as it's going all the way down, it's extending all the way to the floor.
Okay.
Even though there is no wall here, the wall is here.
Okay.
Pitik. But so when did everyone, Rav and Shmuel, agree that these walls are viewed as a valid partition between the roof, and carrying each roof is unreservedly permitted? That's v'mechitzus hanikoris, right? V'mechitzus hanikoris means when the walls are visible, no one argues. Rav and Shmuel both agree. What happens v'mechitzus she'en hanikoris? So mechitzus she'en hanikoris, walls that are not visible. Rav omar ein metaltin bo'la b'dal damis. Rav says we may not carry on either roof except within four amis. Lo yomar gud asik mechitzoso, because he does not apply the rule of extend and raise up.
Why he decided not to apply? It's a rule from the Torah.
No, he says it's not. In his opinion, it doesn't apply to here. It doesn't apply to our case. He says, I'm not denying Aloch L'Moshe M'Sinai, God forbid. I'm saying that it doesn't apply to our case. Rav said we may not carry on either roof except within four ames. Why? Because he does not apply the rule of extend and raise up the partition to a covered wall. Shmuel says it is permitted to carry on the entire roof. The Omar Gud Asik Mechitzoso, because he applies the rule of extend and raise up the partition even to a covered walls, and these walls serve to partition the area above. So in the present case, since the two buildings are separated by walls, carrying on each roof is permitted. So if there is a separation, I'm allowed to carry, because you have an A roof, you have a wall, even though it doesn't exist. But if you don't apply the rule of good asik, and there's no wall, and you can't carry. So that was the Rav said, we do not apply it, and therefore you're not allowed to carry.
Sorry.
We may not carry. Comes Shmuel, and he says, we are applying the rule, and therefore you should be able to carry. Nan v'chachomim kol echad v'echad, we learned in our Mishnah, Sages says each roof reshus la'atzmoi. Each roof is a domain unto itself. This implies that although carrying between the roofs is prohibited, each roof in itself is an entirely permitted area. Right, from one roof to another, don't carry, but the roof itself is your area, so you should be allowed to carry there. This is understandable, that this fits well with the view of Shmuel, who permits carrying unreservedly on each roof. But prohibit carrying on each roof beyond four amis is difficult. Why shouldn't he carry? It's his domain. So they say in the Academy of Rav, in the name of Rav, Mishnah means, Shelo yetaltel beis amis begag ze ubeis amis begag ze. That one may not carry an object, two amis on this roof, and two amis on this roof. Which means, the Mishnah could mean that each roof is a separate domain, and carrying within four amis is permitted. Whereas carrying from roof to roof is forbidden even within four amis. So again, Omri Bei Rav Mishmei De Rav, Shelo Yetalter Beisam Begagzeh Beisam Begagzeh. One may not carry an object, two amis, on this roof, and two amis on this roof. The Mishnah could mean that each roof is a separate domain, and carrying within four amis is permitted, whereas carrying from roof to roof is forbidden even within four amis. If that's the case, V'amar Rabbi Lozor Ki Avinan B'bovel Av Amrinan B'Rav Mishmei D'Rav Omru En Metaltim Bo L'Dalad Amis. In the name of Rav, they said that we may not carry on each of the roofs except within four amis. V'ane Devei Shmuel Tonu En Lame L'Gagon. But in the Academy of Shmuel, they, the owners of each roof, have only their own roof upon which to carry. Mai Ein Lo En L'Gagon. What does it mean? They have only their own roof. Love the shoulder taltule bechule. Does it mean that they are not? That does it mean that they are permitted to carry on the entire roof? And the Baisa supports Shmuel's opinion. Umi alima mimasnisin. But is the wording of this Baisa a stronger proof than the wording of the Mishnah, which means to permit carrying throughout the roof? Which we established, one may not carry two amis on this roof and two amis on someone else's roof. Here too, the Baita can be explained to mean that one may not carry two amis on this roof and two amis on this roof, whereas carrying on each roof is permitted, but only within four amis, as Rav had taught. Amar Rav Yosef. Right, the aforementioned view of Shmuel, that the rule of good asik applies even to a covered wall. Rav questions of Yosef. I'm obviously Lushmi Aleo Shmaito. Obviously, I have not heard this teaching of Shmuel. I do not believe that Shmuel ever said it. I'm Ola Bayat Amot Nialan Bayat Omot Nialan. Abaye said to him, you yourself told us this ruling of Shmuel, and it was in regard to this following Mishnah. What was the ruling? Gag godel samuch lekotan, a large roof, which is samuch, is adjacent to a small roof. Hagod mutar hakotan also. Carrying on the large roof is permitted because it is legally enclosed on four sides, but carrying on the small roof is prohibited because it is completely open to the large roof. V'amart lan Allah, v'amart lan Allah. And Rav Yosef told us about this Mishnah. Amar Yehuda ben Shmuel. Rav Yehuda said in the name of Shmuel, lo yishon lo shesh diyun al zeh v'diyun al zeh. The Mishnah did not teach that carrying on the small roof is prohibited except when there are residents on both roofs who constantly walk from one roof to the other. The cotton mechitzoni dresses. For in such a case, this fourth wall of the small roof is a wall that is trod upon, which prevents applying the rule of good asik to it. The small roof is without a fourth wall, and carrying there is forbidden. Aval ein diurin al zeh v'al zeh shnei mutorin. But if there are not residents on both roofs, there is not a constant flow of traffic between the roofs, and carrying on both roofs is permitted. So since we view the wall under the roofs as extending upward and partitioning the small roofs fourth side, Rav Yosef himself had taught Shmuel's view that good asik applies to a covered wall, provided there is not a constant flow of traffic over that wall. Rav Yosef, however, asserts that Abaye misquoted the teaching of Rav Yehuda in the name of Shmuel, that Rav Yosef had taught him. Amar le ana hachi amri lechu. This is what I, in fact, I told you in the name of Shmuel. Lo yishonu ele shesh mechitza zeh mechitza zeh. The Mishnah did not teach that carrying on the large roof is permitted except when both roofs have actual walls on top of them. They have actual walls. The godlu mishtare begifuve, for in such a case, carrying on the large roof is permitted because of the actual side post. And you have in the picture, it shows you a roof that has a wall around it. You can see the difference between picture one, image one and image two. One image has a wall around the edge of the roof. Mm-hmm. It has a mechitza.
Yeah.
Actual walls on top of them. The godlo mishtar begifufei, the large roof is permitted because of the actual side posts that begin to partition.
This is like a lechi?
No, it's a mechitza. It's a real mechitza. Vekoto nifat v'mloyo, whereas the small roof is entirely open to the large roof, and carrying on the small roof is therefore prohibited. Yeah, I guess the one would be called the small roof, and one is the big roof. The large area, the small area. Kot infatsim loyo, whereas the small roof is entirely open. Aval en mechitza lo azeh lo azeh, shneim asur. But if there's no mechitza, but if neither roof has an actual wall on top of it, carrying both roof is prohibited. That was the first picture, that there's no mechitza, said you shouldn't be carrying. But I remember clearly that you told us that something regarding residents on the roofs. This would fit with Rav's recollection of what Rav Yosef had taught him, but not with Rav Yosef's recollection. He said, if I said to you anything about residents, this is what I must have said to you. Lo yishanu, the Mishnah did not teach that carrying on the small roof is prohibited. Except when there is a wall fit for residential use on each roof. Each roof is enclosed by a sturdy wall. It's a good wall, which shows that its residents intend to use the roof for residential purposes. The godlo mishtar begifufei, for in this case, carrying on the large roof is permitted because of the side post that begin to partition its fourth side, on either side of the small roof, as the small roof is entirely open to the large roof, and carrying on the small roof is therefore prohibited. However, if there is a wall fit for residential use on the large roof, but there's not a wall fit for residential use on the small roof, this indicates that the residents of the smaller building have no intentions of using the roof area regularly. In this case, afilu koton shor livne godol, even the small roof is an area permitted for carrying to the residents of the large roof. My time, kevon de loyavud mechitzos, since they did not construct a suitable wall. Saluki saliku nafsham me'acha, they have removed themselves from here. They removed themselves from the small roof and have in fact given over the right to use the roof to the residents of the large roof, meaning the people of the small roof, since they did not make a partition, a mechitza, it shows that they did not plan to use the roof. So they, in a way, they gave over permission, they gave over the rights to the residents of the big roof. Ki adam of Nachman, also son kavol egag uta b'chol egag kula. It says, in the case of several adjoining roofs, if the owner of one of them set up a permanent ladder so that he would have access to his roof, he is permitted to carry on all the roofs. Because other people didn't do it, obviously they're not using the roof, so it became almost, it's not his, but he has the permission not to use, halachically to use the entire place. Amar Abaye bona aliyos al gibbe beisai. Abaye said, if the owner of one of them built a second story on top of his house. But also for now, you can see in the diagram, somebody built a second story. But also for now, Dako Arba, and he made in front of it a narrow doorway. You can see the doorway, narrow doorway. Uta b'chol gayin kol yezer. Now he is allowed to use the entire roof.
The first roof and the second roof.
No, the second picture.
There's not two roofs, there's one roof.
No, this is not considered a roof.
No, this, so the guy that lives here now is allowed to use the entire roof, this entire space.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? In the other picture, the window is looking outside. It doesn't have access to the roof.
Yeah.
In the first picture, he has access to the roof.
Yeah.
Rav said sometimes the narrow opening that one makes for his second story causes a prohibition. How does it cause prohibition? When the opening is made on the side wall that is towards his house garden. That's the second picture. Rather than in his wall facing the roof. Damar, for in this case, one who sees this arrangement says to himself, it was made in order to watch. He made a window to watch over his garden.
But not
in order to use the roof area. In effect, this homeowner has renounced his rights to use the roof area. Okay. This actually reminds me